My name is Esteban Science, and this is a science documentary. My grandma Manuela Science was born in Colombia and Banderas on February 28, 1938. A year after her birth, my grandma, my great grandparents, and the people living in Banderas were forced to move out after a great storm hit Banderas and flooded the whole city. For months of traveling, they stepped in deserts, mountains, and rocky roads just to find a new home in Mexico. After a year traveling, they found a new home in Durango, Mexico. The year 1940, Mexico was elected a new president named Manuel Ávila Camacho. He also served his country in Mexico during World War II. Between the years of 1939 to 1945. During Ávila Camacho's term, the conflict between the Roman Catholic Church in Mexico and the Mexican state largely ended. Mexico had two ships, one called Potrero de Llano and the other called Faja de Oro, or a band of gold. Both ships sailed across the world for many companies around the world and did service for the war in World War I. In World War II, while carrying oil, both ships were destroyed by German submarines while sailing under the Mexican flag in the Gulf of Mexico. After what happened to the ships, Ávila Camacho declared war against the Axis powers on May 22, 1942. In 1943, US President Roosevelt and Mexican President Camacho had dinner in Panama while talking about being allies together in World War II. Mexican soldiers coming to the United States to serve were called braceros.
Imagine leaving your home and everything that's familiar, saying goodbye to family and friends, to work in the fields, on farms, on the railroads, in a country other than your own. That is what millions of Mexican men did between 1942 and 1964. They were called braceros, from the Spanish word for arms, brazos. These strong-armed men came over the border to work in the United States, initially filling a void left by American men going overseas to fight in World War II.
My grandpa Ramon Sainz was one of the 15,000 people to serve Mexico in World War II. After winning World War II, my grandpa was granted citizenship and was able to stay in the United States. He moved to El Paso, Texas, where he could be close to home in Mexico. My grandparents met while my grandma was visiting El Paso for vacation. 4 years later, they got married, and my grandma moved to El Paso and stayed with my grandpa. This is a picture of the house where my grandparents lived for almost over 25 years. Here's my grandpa and my dad. A year before I was born, my grandpa passed away with a heart attack. Me and the rest of my family were born and raised in El Paso, and we still continue to be very close. I rarely see my grandma, but once I do, I cherish every minute I have with her. If I only knew how my grandpa was really like. This was a science documentary. Thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed it like I did.